2 million kilometers away from Earth, out there in the frozen depths of space, there lurks a giant 500 meter wide asteroid, one that could eventually collide with Earth. And right now, a NASA spacecraft is orbiting this asteroid, studying its every detail. The OSIRIS-REx probe arrived at Bennu, the asteroid in question, back in December of 2018, with plans to carefully survey it and collect a 60-gram sample of the stuff the asteroid is made up of. And that's all before beginning the two-year return journey to Earth in 2021. We definitely want to know more about this asteroid, but just how likely is it that Bennu could hit Earth? And if it is on a collision course with us, what could we possibly do about it? NASA may be the name you recognize when it comes to sending little metal guys out into space to explore stuff, but we have our own experts here at Lawrence Livermore dedicated to understanding just what is out there, what exactly we might need to be prepared for, and what we could actually do about it.
Planetary defense is kind of what it sounds like. If we have a threat to the world or to some part of the world, we want to have a plan on how to defend it. The threat that we're concerned with are asteroids and other large pieces of space debris that might come and smack us.
Planetary defense? Man, that sounds so cool. And then it actually is so cool. Protecting the planet from asteroid and meteor impacts? I mean, these guys are real life superheroes. They should wear capes.
No capes!
Okay, but back to Bennu. What is it? And should we be worried?
The concept of asteroid impacts and planetary defense really resonates with a lot of people, and I think the public connects really readily with that, and there is the potential for the probabilities of real disasters to be exaggerated sometimes. So it's important to stay grounded in reality. For Bennu, the odds are still very, very small that it will impact the Earth, about 1 in 2700 in the late 22nd century. So, well after any of us will be around, between 2175 and 2199, there's a 1 in 2700 chance that it could impact Earth. Bennu is a really interesting asteroid, and it is worthy of a lot of study because it has this very convenient orbit, or it comes by the Earth a lot, and we could study it a lot. In terms of what keeps me awake at night, Bennu is not that. I worry about all of the thousands of asteroids that are not yet detected that are out there. Most of them much smaller than Bennu. And some of them still could do a lot of damage potentially, the ones that are tens or hundreds of meters in size that we have not yet found. But Bennu itself is not something that I would worry about as a planetary scientist.
So there are lots of asteroids out there. And while we don't necessarily need to be worried about Bennu, it is a really useful model asteroid for us to study to learn more about how we would react to an asteroid that was a threat. So, what is that reaction? What do we do if a massive ball of rock looks like it's gonna come crashing through our atmosphere?
At Lawrence Livermore Lab, we focus on two specific deflection technologies. We're concerned with kinetic impactors, which is essentially crashing a rocket into an asteroid.
Kinetic impacts would likely not be successful in moving Bennu off of an Earth impact trajectory. You would need so many kinetic impactors launched in the dozens, really, even with 25 years warning time, even things that can bring a very large payload to Bennu, it still would not be successful in moving it off of an Earth impact. And so this brings us to the alternative approach, which is to use a nuclear device,
which involves setting off a nuclear device in the proximity of an asteroid so that you give it a gentle nudge so that now it doesn't hit Earth when maybe previously it was on a trajectory with Earth.
So it's like the movie Armageddon?
Armageddon was a very fun film, but it is not based at all in reality. Just to recap, in Armageddon there was an asteroid the size of Texas on a collision course with Earth, and we had an hour to deflect it. And we sent up Bruce Willis and a bunch of other very well-known Hollywood actors to drill a hole, drop a nuke down it, which had to be a very specific depth, detonate the nuclear device, and then have the asteroid break up and miss the Earth. There are not near-Earth asteroids that are the size of Texas. Texas is a surface area, it is not a volume, but even considering that, there are not any asteroids that we're worried about that are that large. We would use a nuclear device in the case where we had very little warning time, but an hour would not be enough. We would need on the order of years. I did a calculation to determine how much energy it would take to deflect an asteroid the size of Texas on a collision course with Earth, and it's about equivalent to the total energy output of the sun in a given day. So we're out of luck.
Okay, so not exactly like Armageddon, but we would send a nuke up into space to blast away an asteroid that might hit Earth. How exactly does that work?
There are two ways to use a nuclear device on an asteroid. The one that we primarily focus on is nuclear deflection. We send up a spacecraft that's carrying a nuclear payload to intercept an asteroid. We then detonate that device some distance from the asteroid, about a third of the asteroid radius, that's a rule of thumb, so that it deposits its energy in the form of X-rays into the asteroid's surface. Now, X-rays don't penetrate very deeply. We're talking about on the order of microns. So we superheat the surface, which then is vaporized and comes screaming off. And that material that's coming off the surface has some momentum, so that you get the equal and opposite. So the material coming off has momentum and equal momentum going to the remaining asteroid body. So the asteroid gets nudged just a little bit so that it then misses Earth.
Success. Unlike the dinosaurs, we hopefully won't be staring helplessly up at the sky when an asteroid looks like it might come barreling toward us. There's stuff we can do, super cool physics stuff that could save us from a devastating hit. But I get the feeling that talking about sending a nuclear device up into space to break up an asteroid might also make some people kinda nervous. Is there anything we should be worried about if we ever have to use the nuclear option on an incoming space rock?
We currently only look at nuclear deflection using what we currently have in our US stockpile. We're not looking to develop anything new. A common concern that I hear is, if we set a nuclear device off in space, are we going to experience a lot of fallout radiation? The answer is no. I am more concerned about the UV rays from the sun. You should probably put on your sunblock every day, SPF 30 or higher. But in terms of a detonation in outer space, that energy is going to be dispersed over an incredibly large volume. And even if it wasn't, we're very well protected by our atmosphere.
I know I, for one, am really glad we have physicists like Megan, Kirsten, and their team working on important questions like this. And there's lots more asteroid and meteor exploring to be done, so make sure you subscribe to this channel and follow us on social to catch even more videos on planetary defense questions that we're exploring here at the lab. Check out the rest of our Inside the Lab playlist here, and as always, thanks for watching.